Ramadan, Saddam Hussein, Osama bin Laden.
Osmation recognition there. Sina Shamadar Damane.
Farsi, Hezbollah.
We received that radio from the terrorists a couple days ago. So, what happened?
One day I was walking my cow, right, in the middle of the street in broad daylight. Then all of a sudden these aliens popped up in their UFO. They sucked up my cow, and then they took me, too.
Oh, what happened?
Are you from America?
No.
Are you from America?
No.
Are you from America?
Okay, don't kill me. Yes, I'm from America.
Tell me about the Maritime Forest.
Oh, I don't know anything about them.
Tell me about the Maritime Forest.
I don't know anything about
them. Tell me about the Maritime Forest.
Okay, don't kill me. I want to live. Okay. I'll tell you everything you want to know about the Maritime Forest.
Wait, you told them about the Maritime Forest?
I mean, what was I supposed to do? I had a big, hairy, smelly terrorist with a gun in my neck, right? I mean, what would you have done?
You told them about the Maritime Forest.
And on the other side, there's this short gangster terrorist. He had his mask on, too.
You told them about the Maritime Forest.
Well...
Okay, fine. Alright, so, Maritime Forests are inhabited by various organisms. No, organisms, not trees. Well, okay, whatever. Including sharks, lions, and dragons. Loblolly trees are a species of indigenous lobsters and are considered a delicacy by the local Native American tribes. These tribes are famous for their magical abilities and mastery of telekinesis. Telekinesis. K-I-N-E-S-I-S. Can I stop now?
No! Keep on going!
Alright. So, hawthorn trees are another famous species of shellfish known for their fire-breathing abilities. In addition to the...
Enough!
No, what are you doing? No!
Well, fortunately, everything you said about the Maritime Forest was wrong. So, no damage was done.
Are you serious, man? Oh, so what is the Maritime Forest?
Well, that's actually classified information. If I told you, I would have to kill you.
Yeah, right. Go right ahead.
Okay, you really want to know?
Maritime Forests, a classified presentation. This is a picture of a Maritime Forest. A Maritime Forest is a climax community of the Barrier Island ecosystem. It is home to a wide variety of flora and fauna, including the famous loblolly pine. The Aztec Lighthouse is also located here. This is another picture of the Maritime Forest. The Maritime Forest starts as a wreck line, which is a residue of various animals and plants which is washed up on the beach. Soon, sand starts building up on this wreck line, upon which pioneer plants grow. These plants enrich the soil, allowing more species to survive in the environment. This process continues, leading to the climax community, which is the Maritime Forest. Here is a diagram of a barrier island. All loblolly pines dominate the upper canopy of the Maritime Forest. The only plants that are able to survive in the understory are the shade-tolerant shrubs. Numerous fruit and twigs provide good living conditions for various animals, including deer, squirrels, and birds. Here is a third picture of the Maritime Forest. The American and Chinese chestnut trees also live in the Maritime Forest. The American chestnut is becoming extinct due to the Chinese chestnut. The Chinese chestnut tree was brought over from Asia and harbors a type of fungus that targets the American chestnut tree. Thus, the American chestnut tree is dying off. This fungi spreads through the palm pores of the Chinese chestnut tree. This is a picture of a chestnut tree. Loblolly trees are a distinguished species of the Maritime Forest. They are made of softwood and spread seeds by fires. It's distinguishable because the branches are only at the top of the tree and the rest of the trunk is bare. It also exudes a citrus smell when under stress, especially when it's in high salinity conditions. However, it is able to survive under these harsh conditions. Here's a picture of a loblolly tree. Fox squirrels are a unique part of the Attatec Maritime Forest. These squirrels were introduced to the area to help their survival as they were becoming endangered. They live in boxes on the sides of trees as they are unable to find homes in the actual trunks because it's soft wood and thus does not make holes. These squirrels are short and stocky and prefer movement on ground. They have no natural predators in the maritime forest. Here's a picture of a fox squirrel. Hawthorn trees are a native species to the maritime forest. Their branches have long spikes, which are used by male northern shrike birds to impale prey. This is a display used to impress female shrikes. Here is a picture of a shrike in its nest. The sassafras tree is another native tree to the maritime forest. The sassafras tree contains carcinogens, which it uses to clear an area around itself. It used to be an ingredient in root beer, though it is not because it causes cancer. The sassafras tree contains three different types of leaves that allow maximum sunlight absorption in a unique pattern. Here is a picture of the unique leaves of a sassafras tree. Now you know about the maritime forest.
Well, how did you escape them anyways?
Alright, so when they were sleeping, I chewed through my ropes, then I walked up to them and I like twisted their necks and I think they just died off. And then I called them my personal helicopter and then we sort of just flew off.
Really?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Well...
Ah! Oh my god! Ah! They're coming! They're coming! Oh my god!
He got away! Why did you not tie the rope?
You had to tie the rope?
Yeah!
Well, that's all very interesting, but since I told you about the maritime forest, I'm gonna have to kill you.
Oh my god!
You can't touch this.
Osama! Saddam Hussein!
You can't just say names!
Alright, I'm still recording. Alright, dude.
Ramadan, Saddam Hussein, this is Ramadan.
Oh, someone bin Laden.
Can't touch this. Yeah, that's how we living in, you know. Oh, he's from America.
Look in my eyes. Choices.